All right. Good evening, everyone. Paul Henderson here, president of Pro Travel Network, ready to get started with tonight's conference call, training call on sales. And we're going to start right at the top. Sales is a process, not an event. And that is so, so true. A lot of people don't know how to sell. They think selling is something that you have to have the gift of gab to do. It's something that you're born with. Some people are good at it. Some people aren't. And that's not true. Sales is a process. It's a learned process. Some people, you know, learn certain things faster than others, but everyone can learn how to sell. Sales has nothing to do with talking. In fact, sales has more to do with listening. And so right from the top, sales is a process, not an event. And there are several steps that go into that. Now, if you did not know what those steps were in the past and you've had some success selling or you've made some sales, you may not know that there was actually some steps that went into that. Becoming a great salesperson, like anything else, is learning how to break down that process into parts and pieces so that you can perfect the process even while you're perfecting each component. So let's just read through these very quickly. These are all part of a successful sale or a sales process. Number one, a professional greeting. Now, we talked the other day about sales and marketing. When you're prospecting for leads and you're doing different things to help bring leads your way, it's important to have professional marketing. But once that client actually moves to the next step, that warm zone, the hot zone, where they're moving from just being a lead and now they're showing interest in becoming an actual client or a buyer. There's another greeting. That's the sales greeting. And this is where you put your hand out. If you're meeting in person, you see the picture here on the screen with a smile, a nice firm handshake. You also do the same thing over the phone. You give the person a nice firm handshake right through the phone and be very cordial. Ask for their information. Hi, how are you? How did you hear about me? My name is Paul Henderson. You know, thank you for calling. A nice, strong, professional greeting. Now, you might think it's not a big deal, but really it sets the tone because people often judge on that first impression. So make sure there's no kids crying in the background. Make sure that, you know, you're ready to go. So a good, strong, professional greeting. Very important. Now, moving into selling yourself, which is probably the most important of all the steps if you took one all by itself. That's selling yourself, building relationship. You are, in fact, unique. What does that mean? Well, a lot of people, when they're selling, they try to sell like they think they're supposed to, or they try to imitate or mimic someone else maybe that they've heard sell. Maybe even myself, you might listen to this conference call and try to imitate some of the things that I say or do, and that's incorrect. What you should do is listen to the things that I say or the different things that other people who are teaching you how to sell, learning various things that they do, but you're supposed to do it with your own personality. You're supposed to do it with your own flair. Everybody's unique. Everybody has worth. Everybody has something that someone else is going to be attracted to. And so you don't want to be Joe salesperson. You want to be yourself. So part of selling yourself is making sure that you give the client time to find a little bit about you and at the same time, some time for you to get to know a little bit about the client. That's very, very important. Typically, most salespeople and especially most travel agents, they don't take that time at all. I challenge you guys tomorrow when you wake up in the morning, just give a call to your local travel agency and tell them that you want to book a flight someplace or you want to go on a vacation someplace, or you want to book a cruise someplace. You'll find that most of them will not spend time finding out about you. They're certainly not going to spend time allowing you to learn a little bit about them. They're just simply in the process of quoting. They want to get down to step number 6 and 7 without doing the first steps that lay the groundwork. Okay? Number 3, sell your company. Selling your company is a very simple step, and it's just simply letting the client know that you work for Pro Travel Network, you work for, or you're partnered with Carnival, you're partnered with the Hyatt, you're partnered with WestJet, that we've been in business, you know, nearly 10 years, that we have agents across the country, that, you know, I can go on and on. So whether you're promoting Pro Travel Network, the company, whether you're promoting your suppliers, selling your company is really just you selling in a very brief way the backbone. You know, who's behind all this. And that's very, very important too. Some of the things, for example, we won't be undersold. You know, we book lots of travel. We're TECO certified. We're registered sellers of travel. These are things that sell the company. Again, selling the company is a very brief step, but again, it's something that you do to let the client know that they're booking from a reputable company. Okay. For example, you know, a lot of times at the office, we'll be selling and someone will call in and, you know, I'll hear Jennifer. She'll ask them how they hear about us. And they'll say, well, we found you on Google. And she'll chuckle and laugh and say, yeah, we were number one on there, huh? Yeah, we get a lot of business from Google. I mean, we, you know, and she'll just start repeating back maybe what the customer said, but she's actually selling the company in a sense. Yeah, we're the largest agency in the entire Central Valley. You probably noticed that, you know, so she's just reaffirming even maybe what the client already thinks or maybe doesn't think. Very important to sell your company. So you're just laying the groundwork as you move through the sales presentation. The next step is qualify. Qualify has nothing to do with money, although a lot of people think it does. How much money do you want to spend? That's the question asked by amateur salespeople. A professional salesperson never has to ask that question because during the qualifying process, a professional salesperson finds that information out without asking that direct question. So in the qualifying process, you're using, guess what? The three steps previous. As you're doing the three steps previous and you're moving into the qualification step, you blend them all together. Because what qualifying is finding out the wants and needs of the client. That's what it is. It has really very little to do with how much money they want to spend. It's the needs of the client. For example, a great qualifying question is, you mentioned that you wanted to go to Hawaii. That sounds like a lot of fun. Have you been to Hawaii before? See, that's a qualifying question. Because I'm going to find out information that's going to help me as I move through this process. Another great qualifying question. Okay, so you went to Hawaii a couple of years ago. What'd you like best about it? Or maybe they've never been to Hawaii. Well, where was the last place you went on vacation? Oh, we went to the Caribbean. We went to Jamaica. Okay, awesome. That's a lot of fun. Where'd you stay? Okay, and as you ask these questions, where did you stay? If a person mentions a resort or a hotel that's maybe a 2-star or a 1-star or 3-star, it starts to formulate in your mind what type of client this person is, you know? Now, you can't draw direct conclusions, but you're just painting a picture of this type of client. Another great question is, you know, how'd you hear about us? Okay, I heard you about it. Great, great. Well, where do you live? Oh, I live in Fresno. Okay, what part? Oh, I live up on blah, 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 blah. Well, guess what? Based on those cross streets of that area, you kind of have an idea of the demographic of this particular client. So what qualifying is finding out how many kids they have, what they do for a living, where they've been on vacation before, what they like best about it, what they didn't like about it, what are they looking for in this new vacation. And as you ask a lot of these questions, what you're really doing is getting to the area where you can then select the perfect vacation for the client, okay? The perfect cruise, the perfect vacation, the perfect package based on what you believe this client wants. All of you on this call, if you've ever sold any travel or maybe sold things in the past, we've all had that experience where we've met somebody and they said, I want to buy this. Or maybe you were the client and you ran into a salesperson and what they did is they said they wanted a particular thing, but after talking, guess what? You find out that they wanted something else and you end up buying something else or the client buys something else. It's because that salesperson takes the time to really find out what you want. For example, you go to Best Buy, you know, and you're looking at the new TV and you've got everything written down exactly what you want. And as a salesperson starts to, now he can just point it to you, okay, that's the one you want, let's go. But if he's very good at what he does, he says, okay, I see you came in on the sales circular and you're looking for the 42-inch TV that we have on special. Great. That's awesome. Let's go take a look at it. Of course, I had a couple questions. Now, why are you buying the TV? Do you already have a big screen TV? Well, you know, we do and we're upgrading. We're moving into the other room and blah, 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 blah. And of course, you know, I'm looking for something where we can watch Monday Night Football. And of course, then he starts talking to you and starts qualifying. And he's finding out a lot of information. Come to find out, you probably might like the 50-inch better. You might like the 60-inch better. Maybe you need the 3D TV. You know, so what he does, he takes the information from you, and then what he does is selects or grabs an idea that he thinks might be better for you based upon the answers that you've given during his qualification process. And based on that, he selects a particular model for you, a particular vacation for you, a particular cruise for you. And once you do the selection process, very simple, you simply present that back to the client. Now, we're going to talk about all these stuff in a little more detail. I'm just going over a quick overview. Presentation is so important because a presentation has nothing to do with price. And unfortunately, many of us think that a presentation is only about price, and it's not. A presentation is simply showing the client that based upon everything that you guys have discussed from the time of the greeting, selling yourself, creating unique identity, selling your company, qualifying, selecting, you're now going to show them what you believe is the perfect vacation for them, the perfect itinerary for them, the perfect cruise for them, the perfect honeymoon destination, the perfect option for them. And you're going to let them know this based on the information that you got in the qualification process. So qualification, select, and presentation, those three steps work together because all they're doing is qualify, asking questions, listening to the responses, using those to go out, do your research, grab the perfect vacation package for the client, and then present it back to them. Now, you're not presenting based on price because if you remember in the qualification step, we didn't focus on price. So therefore, there's no reason to cover price in a presentation. You do that at the end. We're now going to let the client know what we found. We found the perfect resort. You mentioned that you were looking for something that you and your husband could really enjoy yourself and have a lot of quiet time and a lot of personal time and a lot of romantic time. But at the same time, you wanted someplace that the kids would have a great time. And so while you and your husband are doing this, they're able to go do that. And then at the same time, during that time, you guys can do things together. So a vacation where everybody gets something out of that vacation. Here's what I found for you. You mentioned that you want to do something adventurous. You know, you mentioned that you used to like to, you know, go backpacking and whatnot. So what I thought is you really might like to do an adventure type vacation in Costa Rica or something like that. You know, you mentioned that you like to go scuba diving. So what I thought was, as part of your vacation package, we've got this neat little tour where you can actually go scuba diving in one of the most sought after places in the world. And I think you'd love this vacation. So this is what the presentation process is. It's letting the client know that based on everything that you've communicated back and forth, you believe this is the perfect package for them. Once you've presented that information, the client's like, oh man, that sounds awesome. That sounds great. And guess what? It should. Because if you've been listening and doing your job, it's very simple to present back to the client what they're looking for. And when the client says, that sounds great, now we go to the next step, which is the commitment. And we still haven't talked about price yet. Commitment just simply says, well, great. I'm glad you think that that's the perfect vacation package for you. I did a lot of research on that. You know, I took everything that we talked about to help put this together. So really, since it sounds like you guys are really excited about it, are you ready to book this today if I can get you a great deal on it? If I can fit it within your budget? If I can get this within the dollar amounts that you guys are trying to stay in as far as your budget? Okay, I still haven't talked about price. I'm talking around price. I'm going to commit the client. If I could, would you? And we're going to come back to that, but you guys can write that down because we will come back to that. Committing is an if I could, would you buy from me today? So if I can get this and get you a super duper shopper stopper deal on it, are you guys ready to put a deposit down? Or what credit card are you guys going to use to hold this? Okay, this is a commitment question. This is the step that you're going to make it all happen. Now, the client says, absolutely, we're ready to go if, you know, you can fit it within our budget. Great. Now you move to the next step, which is the close. See, price doesn't even come into play until you get down to the very last step. And it's really between commitment and close is the negotiation. You might give a price, client might just say yes. You might give a price and you might have to negotiate a little bit. But again, you do not commit to a price until the client has committed that he wants to buy from you. Again, you guys can try this in the morning. Call a travel agent tomorrow. Tell them what you're looking for. I guarantee you, they will not go through any of these steps before they give you a price. They might call you back, but they're not going to find out much about you. You're not going to find out much about them. They're not going to sell their company. They're not going to spend very much time qualifying you. They're just going to listen to what you say you want. I want to go on a Caribbean cruise. Okay. Where do you want to go? Well, I want to go to the Bahamas. Okay. When do you want to go? I mean, just very cut and dry. They're just going to get right to it because they're order takers. Write that down. Order takers. Order takers work at McDonald's. Salespeople don't. Salespeople understand that value, okay, write that word down. Value is what is built in the sales process. If you do not take the time to go through these steps, if you do not take the time to sell yourself, sell your company, qualify, select, present, commit, and close, you've built no value. So when you do give the client a price, there's no reason why they should say yes because they don't feel like there's any value in it. They don't feel like you really worked. They don't feel like they know you. They don't feel like you took any real time with them. There's no reason to slow them down because they were planning on calling three other agents anyway, and you've not done anything to stop that, right? So it's so important to remember that sales is a process, and that process itself creates value. Value in you. and value in the presentation or the product that you're presenting, which then allows the customer to say, I'm in. That price sounds great. Why? Why does the price sound great? Because it's everything that I wanted. See, when you find something that the client really wants, they will pay for it. A lot of times, clients tell you no, or I'll think about it, or I'll call you back, because the price that you gave, maybe it's not a bad price, but they don't feel like it's a good price. And I want you guys to write this down, and we're going to move into the presentation very quickly. Write this down. The best deal is whatever the client thinks the best deal is. So it doesn't matter what the price is. A client might say yes to $6,000 and he might say yes to $4,000, and it doesn't make any difference. At whatever price he says yes to, that's the best deal. It could be for the same exact booking. See, one of the unique things about being in management in pro travel, of course, being in sales my whole life and being a manager, I always have the opportunity to look down on the sales department in terms of watching each person's sales numbers. So here's a salesperson over here, and he's doing this. Here's another one over here. He's doing that. And it's really interesting that you can take two salespeople who could talk to the same customer, booking the same exact trip or selling the same exact product. One will make a lot more money than the other, but both think they're doing their job. It's so interesting. It's so amazing. One will convince you that he couldn't have got any more money. He is convinced that earning 3% commission was the absolute best he could have done. Yet the other person makes 20% and the customer is just as happy, because price has nothing to do with happiness. Remember, the client is happiest when he says yes. Whether he says yes at, let's say the trip costs $2,000, whether the client says yes at $2,000 or the client says yes at $2,500, he's just as happy. Who's happier at $2,500 though? Which salesperson? The one that sold it for two or the one that sold it for 25? Well, it's the one that sold it for 25. He's happier because he made $500 more commission. Same client, same product, same itinerary. And you know what? The agent who isn't able to do that will swear up and down and will try to convince you that his client was different. Oh, but you don't understand my client. Oh, but you don't understand the people I talk to. Oh, but the people I talk to, they only want the lowest price. Oh, you don't understand. My customers are different. Oh, you don't understand. I'm in the Indian community. They don't. Oh, you don't understand. I'm in the African Americans. Oh, no. Hispanic, they don't book that way. Oh, you've got every excuse in the book. The fact of the matter is they're just excuses. And it's a diversion away from production. And it's a mindset that you have to get away from in order to be very, very successful. You see, when we talked earlier in this series about building a plan where you average 30% commission, a lot of you won't be able to do it simply because you don't believe that you can do it. You have a negative mindset. You might think you're the most positive person in the world, but you have a negative mindset when it comes to sales. You don't believe that it can be done. And then what happens is you try to convince others that it can't be done. And I do this all the time, every day. I talk to agents all day long, and I listen to them. And when they try to explain to me why they couldn't do this or they can't do that, it just goes in one ear and right out the other, because I already know. Because I can just run a report and pull 5 or 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 12, 20 agents that don't just do it every once in a while. They average 20% commission. They average 25% commission. They average 30% commission. So we're not talking about every once in a while. This is the way that they build their business. They build their business based on the concept that wherever the customer says yes, it's a win-win. But see, it's not a win-win. Because if you sell a client, you don't make any money. It's not a win-win. He wins, you lose. Yeah, but Paul, you know, this is a client that I'm going to be able to keep, you know, over and over and over and over again. If you want to believe that, that's okay. I don't necessarily believe that. I don't believe you have to make every client every time to make them your clients all the time. If it falls outside of the guidelines that you need and you've put down in your business plan to be successful, so be it. Clients will respect that. See, you're looking for customers. You're not looking for price shoppers, you know. So remember, you've got to get your mindset right. And we're going to talk about that in just a few minutes, but let's just go through this very, very quickly. Meet and greet, the first step. Within the first 3 seconds of a new encounter, you're being evaluated, even if it's just a glance. When you first meet that client, you've got to give a professional greeting. You've got to smile. You've got to be professional. You've got to be dressed appropriately. You've got to be fun. This is why I tell you guys in sales and marketing, your Facebook page has to look nice, clean, family, fun, not too controversial. You don't want to look like you're looking to pick up. You're not hunting. You want to look like, hey, that's somebody I'd like to deal with as far as business. Body language, grooming, confidence, your branding, everything about you says this person knows what they're doing. That's what we're talking about, getting your About Me page cleaned up. These are all part of your first impression, what they see about you. You might not actually meet the client in person. So what they can see of you, it needs to be professional, good looking. So remember, very, very important, a poor first impression, you won't even get to the second step. You won't make it to step two. Step two, selling yourself, creating that unique identity. Why does it say unique identity? Well, the reason is because it's so important to be different from everybody else. Like I said, I challenge you guys to pick up the phone tomorrow, and call a few travelers and see if you find a unique personality. The odds are you won't. You can call five of them, and five of them will give you a quote within a few minutes, or they may call you back, and within a few minutes you've got a quote in your hand, and you don't know anything about this person. Nothing. Why would you book from them? They're just anybody. You can pick up the phone and do that with anybody. See, the key to developing relationship is allowing yourself and giving yourself some time. Write that down. Giving yourself some time. Giving yourself some time. That means slow it down a little bit. Let this be a process, not an event. Before you jump into pricing, let's talk a little bit. Now, you might not be, comfortable, and it might take a little work because you guys are brand new and you've never really sold before, but it's easily learned. So take the conversation, let the client lead the conversation, and then you take over the conversation. That doesn't mean you do all the talking, but you steer it the way you want to go. For example, client says, hey, I'm interested in going to Hawaii. Awesome, awesome. Have you been to Hawaii before? Well, no, this is our first time. Wow, you know what? I remember the first time I went to Hawaii. It was my first time. It was so much fun. I mean, just getting off that plane, and when they put that layer around your neck, with the flowers and everything, it just makes you feel like, wow. I mean, this is the whole experience ready to get started. And you just start telling some little stories. Now the client knows something about you. You've been to Hawaii. So you haven't been to Hawaii. So where have you been? Well, we went to Jamaica. Jamaica's a lot of fun. What'd you guys do there? Oh, that sounds like a lot of... Who'd you go with? Was there a special occasion? Well, it wasn't, but, my husband's birthday was like the week after. Guess what? Just by asking little questions, letting the customer lead, and then I ask questions, and I take over and start steering that conversation, before you know it, I'm learning so much about this client. As I tell my stories and I do my Me Toos and I've got three kids and my daughter just went off to college and yours too. Yeah, we laugh, and guess what? You start to build a rapport. The person on the other side of the line is starting to think, I have a few things in common with this person. I've called three other places and didn't have one thing in common. They might even been next door neighbors, but the other person the other salesperson is so bad, they would have never even found that out. And a lot of times I use examples in the office sometimes. It was interesting that one of the girls in the office made a booking. And right at the end of the booking, she found out that the booking actually belonged to one of the other people in the office. The client had already talked to somebody in the office. And I simply said, as we were talking, I said, you know what that means? I said, you didn't do your job. You didn't do enough qualifying. You didn't create a unique identity. You didn't sell yourself. Because if you had, you would have found out right away that the client had already been in here. How can you sit here and be with a client for 25 minutes and not even know that they were here last week talking to someone else? Does that make sense, everybody? So it means that you're not asking the right questions. You're not developing that unique identity. You're not giving that give and take. You're afraid. You're just selling travel. We're selling itineraries. But we don't sell itineraries. We sell people. We sell ourselves. We sell relationship. Now, the sales process requires you, over time, it's not something you immediately learn, but over time to learn various personality types. I'm going to quickly go through these. Talkers versus listeners. If you have somebody in front of you that's very, very talkative, you just listen. Let them talk. If people enjoy talking, guess what? It makes them like you better when you listen. It's okay. If they're very quiet, you need to do the talking. Okay? You've got to ask some good questions, get some good responses. You have to do the talking until that gap is closed. Okay? Introvert versus extrovert. You have to be able to recognize, fill in the gap, okay? Where there's awkwardness, you have to fill in and fix it until the point where you guys are both communicating, okay? Dolphin, whale, urchin, and shark. These are just personality types. We use sea creatures to describe them very briefly. Dolphin is somebody who just likes to have fun. Dolphins are easy. Extroverts, talkers, they're going to book from you anyway. As long as you're not a stick in the mud, they're ready to go. Let's do it! right? That's a dolphin. How much is it? I'm in. That's a dolphin. They just want to go. They just want to go. Not a lot of questions. Sounds like a lot of fun. Let's do it. We're in. We're ready to go. Dolphins are easy. Dolphins are many times what we call the laydowns. Dolphins many times fool you because you think you're a great salesperson because you sold a dolphin. Anybody can sell a dolphin. Dolphins are easy. That's their personality type. Great people, dolphins. Whales are a little bit slower, but whales are very nice people that they need to feel like you actually care about who they are and what they're about. Whales are people who love to help people out. They're community people, community oriented. These people are members of this and members of that. You know, whales tend to travel in groups a lot, okay? And whales, for them, it's very important that they feel like you're part of their community. You're a like-minded person, okay? So you need to make sure that with whales, you do a lot of storytelling and sharing, okay? That's a whale. Urchin. An urchin is a computer engineer, civil engineer. He's got glasses on. He's got a pocket protector and 20 pens in his pocket. He wants to know everything about the booking. He wants you to know up front he's going to go talk to 5 different people. He's going to get their best price. He's going to get all the details, the itineraries, to make sure they all match 100%. He wants to know what's available to do at every single stop, every port when he gets there. He wants to know how many miles from this to this. He wants to know everything, and he wants to let you know he's going to shop you. He wants you to give him all the information and more and more and more and more. And once you give all that information, he might buy and he might not. He's going to make an informed decision. That's an urchin. Scares you to death. God, I'm going to waste so much time with this person. He's not going to buy. He's just going to call 5 different other people. Most of us either spend way too much time with an urchin or we don't spend any time. But you know what? Urchins are easy as well. All you have to do with an urchin is exhaust that need that they have to feel that they've done their homework. That's exactly what the sales process is about. See, an urchin isn't interested in someone giving them a 5-minute quote because they'll take that quote and call somebody else. The person who takes the time to give them the information, but not just the information, but takes the time to build relationship and communicate and really slow it down. See, the urchin just needs to feel like he's done his homework. And once you've already taken a couple hours with an urchin, he's not going to want to spend 2 more hours with this person and 2 more hours with that person. So an urchin just needs to feel like you're spending lots of time with them. But I didn't say you had to shortcut the sales process. You still don't have to give them, go jump right to price. You simply spend a lot of time qualifying an urchin, letting him know that you're still looking and you want to make sure this is the perfect trip for him. He will love that. Urchins love the fact that you're urchining them back, and it's all a game. The sales process is a game. It's business, but it's simply a process of learning how to deal with various personality types through the sales process. So the sales process itself, as it slows it down, allows you to deal with all the personality types. By definition, that's what it does. Shark. A shark is a professional, doctor, lawyer, okay, politician, business owner, busy, owns his own business, upper management, doesn't have a whole lot of time for this. Look, I just need to get the best price. I don't have a lot of time. I need that so we can go ahead and, you know, I'm not going to make a decision. I need the best price. And he scares you. They're rough. You ask him some questions and you're trying to, you know, do your process and he just derails you. What do you need to know that for? Where'd we go on vacation last? Why does that matter? I mean, a shark just, he's a shark. He's alpha. How do you deal with a shark? The same way. You let the sales process do it. You simply have to get good at asking the right questions. How do you beat a shark? You edify. Write that down. You edify a shark. A shark just wants to know he's the deal. If you let a shark know he's the deal, he'll do anything you want him to do. Doctor so-and-so, wow, you know that, how long did it take you to become a doctor? Really? Really? How big's your practice? Wow. Wow. Where's your business at? And what do you guys do? Really? See, you still go through the same process. You're creating a unique identity. You're listening. But with the shark, you have to edify. They want to know that they're a shark. And when you give that up to them, they just lay down. They just lay down. Sharks, many times, will be your greatest clients. These are the clients that will give you their credit card and just let you have it. Hey, Jessica, this is John. Oh, hi, John. Hey, I need to go to blah, 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 blah. You already have my credit card on file. Can you just take care of that for me? Just go ahead and email it to me. Okay, they just want to feel like they've got somebody in their pocket that'll take care of them. That's a shark. You just have to get through that first sale. Once they realize that you appreciate them, respect them in what they're sharking at, or whatever they're a shark in, guess what? They lay down. You become their personal travel agent. They like to feel that. And guess what? Don't you too? Isn't it neat to have a client call you and just say, handle it, and you don't have to even go through any sales process is over. See, sharks, you only have to do the sales process many times just once. Once you do it once, they're done for life. Jessica, can you book me a flight to Vegas and just get me a nice hotel? Sure. Done. That's a shark. So each of these personality types, and people are a blend. Many times they're not one, they're a blend of some of these. But as you begin to learn how to deal with these various personality types by using the sales process, slowing it down, developing that unique identity, you need to be whoever that client needs you to be to make the sale. This is the core of the sales process, developing common ground. These are the me toos. You're married? Me too. Children? Me too. What school did you go to? Oh, me too. You like to do this? Oh, me too. See, these are great qualifying and selling yourself type questions when you're building relationships. The me toos. Okay, write that down. The me toos. Okay? Sell the company. Again, we talked about this. Just building credibility. Talking about Pro Travel Network. But again, it can be more than that. It can also be selling your suppliers. The fact that we're TECO certified, we're members of ITA, we're one of CLIA's top, you know, entities. We're one of vacation.com's top agencies. We're the number one agency in the area. I mean, it doesn't matter. It's just, again, you don't need to oversell here. It's not needed. It's just simply letting them know what's behind you, the backup, okay? Qualifying. Ask and listen, ask and listen. Ask and listen, ask and listen. Has nothing to do with money. Has everything to do with the wants and needs of the client. Look at these pictures. Someone sold these people a vacation, but did they sell them the vacation and build value in it? See, once the client gets to the destination, they're going to have fun anyway. But did the agent make any money? Did the agent build huge value in it? See, each of these tells a story. There's a dad, couple kids. They're at Epcot. They're at Disney. Dad comes in and says, hey, you know what? I'm interested in going to Disney with my family. Can you let me know what the price is on that? Maybe 5 days? See, just very cut and dry. Very, 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 very blah, very straight, right? Depending on if he's an urchin, dolphin, his personality type, he's going to ask you that question. But guess what's behind that? What's behind that? He's been working for 2 years. He hasn't taken the kids on a vacation in a long time. Mama's been on his butt. She wants to go on vacation. He's been promising and promising and promising, and he hasn't taken the kids anywhere. That's what's behind it. He's not going to tell you that, but you need to find that out. Because once you find out why he wants to go to Disney World with the kids, once you find out why, you can then work on that why. And it's just a matter of the sales process. Once you get to know them, you know, he'll just open up to you. Yeah, I haven't taken the kids anywhere in a couple of years. I just want to do something really special for them, you know. Or, you know, like in the office the other day, a guy came in and, you know, his daughter had some kind of, you know, disease. And, you know, they wanted to do something really special for her. You know, they didn't know how much time they were going to have with her. You know, if you don't ask the right questions, you're not going to find out that kind of stuff. But once you find out, guess what? You can then join with the client to make it the best vacation ever. You know what, sir? I'm going to make sure that you and your family remember this vacation for the rest of your lives. You may not have taken them in the last couple of years, but they're going to remember this forever. Great. That's what I'm looking for. You know, Jessica at the office, she's amazing at it. I listen to her all the time, and some of the other girls are really good as well. Couple comes in, or gal comes in, or guy, doesn't make a difference, and they want to go somewhere, and they're good at asking great questions, great leading questions. Are you guys celebrating anything special? Oh, well, no, you know, but, you know, I thought about it. You know what? This is a great time to do something really special. Or if this is your first event, you know, if you're talking to a man, we're going to make this the best vacation ever. You want to impress your wife? Let me help you do that. Really? So you want to get on their side. You want to help make this the best vacation ever. But if you don't know why they're going, you can't do that. You're just an order taker. So that's why qualifying is so important, because if you can ask the right questions, and then you can show them how you're going to help them make this the most awesome vacation, guess what? They'll pay for it. When you finally let them know what the actual pricing is for it, they're in, because you built the value so high. They can see it with their eyes. That's why qualifying is so important. Don't just take the client's word for it. Don't just assume, I want to go to Hawaii for 5 days on March the 15th. We want a nonstop flight. We want to go snorkeling. Don't just take that. You've got to ask the right questions. Why do they want to go? What do they like to do? What can I do to help make this special? You haven't been on vacation 2 years? Oh, you know what? I'm going to put some special attention on this. We're going to make this so you... These are the kind of things that make people go, okay, you're building value. Value in your services, value in what you ultimately select for them, and ultimately that value turns into commission for you. Qualifying is two parts. You want to determine what the customer is most willing to buy. So there is that trying to find out where they want to go. But at the same time, what are you most likely to sell? You know, client might say they want this, but as you start talking to them, you start scratching your head, but there's no way they can do that. Something's not jiving. Just in your brain, it's not jiving. They want to go to Fiji, but they're talking about Fiji, but it sounds like they're on a, you know, amusement park budget. So these are things that you find out during the qualifying process. You've got to take notes point by point. You've got to listen intently for the hot buttons. What makes them smile? What makes them start talking? What makes them look at each other? What starts a conversation on a completely new tangent? These are where you're going to find out what this person really wants out of a vacation. Just because they picked up a cruise magazine and called you, you know, about a cruise, doesn't mean that the cruise is the best option for them. It's your job to listen and find out what that best option is for them. And so you've got to qualify properly. Now, select. You select, not the client. That just simply means just because the client says, I want to go to Hawaii, does not mean you should spend all day researching Hawaii. You should spend your time qualifying, talking to the client. You know, at the home office, you know, I tell the girls, don't ever quote until you talk to the client three times. Three times. Three separate phone calls. Well, Paul, what are the phone calls for? Just to build rapport. Find out a little bit more about the customer. Let the customer know how hard you're working for them. Let them know it's a process, not an event, that you've been working on it. You had a few more questions. You found something, but you just wanted to make sure that this is, you know, what they're looking for, so you can go back and do a little more due diligence. Okay? That's how you build value. If you call in 5 minutes, what value have you built? Are you worth a commission because you spent 5 minutes quoting a client? You certainly won't sell an urchin like that. So very, very important that you select based on what you heard and what you learned in the qualifying and the building relationship steps. So selection is really about spending time going over the previous qualifying step, the notes that you took, to determine the best trip to present back to the customer. And it's based on their wants and needs, not on price. Presentation. Now, presentation can be over the phone, it can be in person, it can be informal, it can be formal, just depends. But the presentation is your opportunity to let the customer know that you were listening. This is where you prove to the client that you are the best at what you do. You heard them. You heard what they were saying. You heard what they were saying with their mouth. You heard what they were saying with their heart. You heard what they were saying with their expressions. You heard them. And here's what you found. And then what you're going to do is you're going to repeat back to them everything that they said and how that is going to be satisfied with what you chose. You wanted this. This has it. This resort has this. Remember we were talking about that? You're going to have an amazing... The kids are going to be able to do this, 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 and this, and you and your husband are going to be able to do this. You mentioned that you guys like adventure. This resort has this, and we've got this shore trip set up so you guys can go do this on this day. So now what you're doing is you're going point by point, letting them know how this itinerary satisfies their expressed desires. This is where you prove you're not an order taker. This is where you prove that you can do more than just, did you want to supersize that? Did you want to add large fries with that? Did you want a large Coke with that? This is it. The presentation is the proof that you've done your job. The presentation is where you build value. Now it starts to increase because as you're going point by point, they're going, that's what we wanted. Yep, 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 let's do it. Boy, that's, I'm ready. That's it. You're right. Let's do it. Perfect. That sounds so amazing. Once you get them to that point, that ether, now you need to commit them. So if I could, we've just seen this, 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 and this. You said it sounds great. It sounds like the perfect vacation. So if I could, you just move right into the commitment. So if I could, dot, dot, dot. What's the dot, dot, dot? Well, whatever it is. So if I could get this in your budget, if I could get this trip in the summertime, if I could get all of you in the same cabin, if I can get you that handicap room, if I can get you in at the last minute because this is selling out, if I can get you front row seats, right? Whatever it is, whatever the hot buttons for the client are. They're not always price. Clients have lots of hot buttons. If I could, would you, dot, dot, dot. Are you ready to make your deposit? Are you ready to buy it today? What credit card are you going to be using? You just move right into the commitment. However, This is where most people lose the sale. Why do I say lose the sale? Because you've been working your butt off. See, selling is not so simple. It's work, but it should be fun after a while. Once you learn it, it becomes habit. But this is where most people lose the sale. They work without a commitment. They quote without a commitment. They work for free. See, up to this point, it doesn't take a whole lot of work. It doesn't take a whole lot of research. Now you say, well, Paul, you just said that you did some research and you repeated back to the client everything they want. Yeah, in an overview. We already know what Jamaica's like. We know what a cruise is like. We know what various destinations are like. We don't have to spend all day researching it. We don't really have to do much research at all. When we're doing a presentation, we're just simply letting the client know that I found a basic resort, or I found a particular this, a particular that. It's got all of these things. But I really haven't gone in and done that much research on it yet. Why? Because I don't have a commitment yet. The commitment is what puts me to work. The commitment gives us control over any future negotiation. See, most of you, what you're doing is you're giving the client a price, and the client's never said he was going to buy it from you. Therefore, when he doesn't call back, there's no reason for him to call back. He never said he was going to call back. He never said he had to call back. He never said he was going to buy it from you. But see, when you, if I could, would you? Whatever the if I could, would you is, if the client says, yes, if you can get that in my budget, we will do it. That sounds good. If you can get me the best price, we'll do it. Well, what's the best price? Whatever the client thinks it is. It doesn't mean anything. See, the commitment, in fact, I want you guys to all write this down very quickly. A commitment is an agreement to buy with or without conditions. See, with or without conditions. You don't have to have everything laid out there yet. Just like a real estate agent. You have to sign a contract, right? An agreement to buy with or without conditions. Why are travel agents the only people that seemingly work for free? Maybe I should try taking my car in for service and see if they'll service it for free. See if they'll diagnose it for free for me. See if I can get this lawyer to give me a couple hours free consultation. No, we're the only ones that spend a lot of time working without a commitment. Nobody else will do it. So this is where we lose it. Without a commitment, we work for free. The commitment gives us control over any future negotiation. Well, how does that work? Well, if the client says, if you can get me the best price, I will book it from you. Then, when you give them the price and they say no, guess what? You can come back to them and say, well, wait a minute. You said that you would buy it from me if I gave you the best price. Well, yes, I did say that. But that price you gave me is not the best price. Well, great. Then what you're saying is we just have to negotiate now to find the best price. But as long as we can do that, you and I have an agreement. Yes. You see what I'm saying? There's actually a gentleman's agreement to do business if we can agree to terms. But some of you are quoting without that agreement, which means you have no gentleman's agreement. And so when you give that quote, it's bye-bye. Thank you. I appreciate it. We'll get back to you. And you have nothing to tie the customer down. You can't say, well, hold on. Wait a minute. What were you thinking? They don't have to tell you anything because they've never said they were going to buy it from you at any price or at any condition. So the commitment is important. The commitment then moves us into the negotiation process. The only job we have prior to getting a commitment is building value. We're not talking about price. We're just building value in us, our relationship, who we are, the work we're putting in, even though you may not be putting in any work at all, until we get to that commitment. Once that customer gets that commitment, game on. Now, I'm willing to research for an hour, 2 hours, whatever it takes to find the perfect everything. Plan it out, get the dates down, get everything detailed out, everything. But you've got to have that commitment. So really, what is the sales process all about? We can boil it down into two things. Building value and getting a commitment. That's really it. Building value is the greeting, creating relationship, selling the company, qualifying, select, present. All of that is part of building value. So if you understand that, think about how many times you quoted a client and you did not build value. You just jumped right to the end. Then you skipped commitment completely and you just gave them a quote. You can see how far off base that is. You can start to understand why your closing ratio is so low, why you're doing 1 out of 10 when you could be doing 4, 5, or 6 out of 10. Great salespeople who build relationships close 4 to 6 out of 10 because it's the value that they're building. You can't build value in 5 minutes. Think about it for a second as we go to the next slide. If you took your car into service, it was acting up, right? You took it in for service. You drop it off. They give you a rental car for the day. You drive off the parking lot and within 15 minutes they call you back. Your car's ready. Really? Yeah, it's ready. Come on back and get it. You go back and they give you a bill for $1,500. How do you feel? Do you feel cheated? Do you feel like, I wonder what was, maybe there was nothing really wrong with that, right? You feel used, you're questioning because there's no value. See, a lot of times they do fix your car in 15, 20 minutes. They just keep it all day so you don't think that it only took 15, 20 minutes. That's how you build value. The whole process is designed to build value in their work. You don't have to stay in front of the computer all day to build value. You just have to make the customer believe that that's what you're doing. You have to spend time on the phone talking about family, determining what the hot buttons are. That's where you build value. So again, you call, agent gives you a quote in a few minutes. Guess what? There's no value there. You don't want to pay $5,000 for that. God, I could have found that online. Maybe, and that's what they're thinking. Maybe I should go on Google and search that. Maybe we should go on Travelocity. That was quick, right? You want to make them believe that there's some magic dust that goes on, some magic supercomputer system that only you have access because you're researching travel for the various planets. There's something that you can do that nobody else can do. Your education allows you to do things that nobody can do. Guess what? Isn't that what it's all about? So building value, get the commitment, and then quote and close. Once you get that commitment, you go ahead and quote them, and you close them. Closing is just simply whatever negotiation needs to be done, just go ahead and do it. If you need to drop $100, $200, if you need to throw in the floor mats, if you need to, you know, just convince them that this is the best deal, whatever, just whatever you need to do to close that deal. But if you've built value, the close is easy. Just ask for the credit card. Don't be afraid. Well, great. I'm glad. Well, you know what? The price on this, let me call you right back or whatever you need to do. Okay, well, you know what? I got it. We locked it in and they're willing to hold it for another hour and a half. So we got it. All I need from you is the credit card. Your price is $8,699, and I got it for you. It's being held right now, so I just need your credit card number. Did you want to pay it in full? Did you want to put a deposit? I forgot to ask you that. You immediately put them into a position of answering your question. Well, I was thinking about putting, you know, $1,000 down. Okay, that's fine. What credit card do you want to use? And they just pull it out. You'll be shocked at how many people will just pull out their credit card when you ask for it. But it's all based on the commitment. The commitment is what gives you the confidence to ask for it. That's why commitment is so important, because you know where the client stands. You know what the commitment is based on. Well, if you can get us on that sailing, you know, I know it's Christmas time and I know, but if you can get us on that sailing and get us a great deal, we're in. Whatever that hot button is, well, if you can get it, keep it in our budget, you know, we're in. You don't even have to ask them what their budget is. You know what? I think I got it. And I think I'm going to stay right within your budget. I've never even asked them what their budget was the entire time we've talked. I don't know if it's $2,000 or $8,000, but just based on the qualifying questions and in talking, I know what these people want and the value they want to go. See, when people value something and there's value, they'll spend more to get it anyway. Even if they had $4,000 in mind, you quote them six. Can we put a down payment on that? Sure. How much did you want to put down? Great. What credit card are you going to use? Because the value is there. So value, commitment, close. Value, commitment, close. The biggest part of that is building value. Once you build value, don't lose it. You've got to anchor it down with the commitment. After that, the quote and close is easy. It really is. Just ask for the money. Be confident. You've already got a commitment. Lean on the commitment. If it starts to slip away, lean on the commitment. Well, John, I'm a little curious. We already talked about, you said you love the trip. You said you're ready to buy it. We're going to do business. So is there something I'm missing? I just wanted to make sure that we had enough money on the card, or I just want to check with I want to check with that, and just lean on that commitment. Okay, well, you know what? Here's what I can do. Let's just do this, and then we'll go ahead and do this, and you just do whatever you need to do to close it. Lean on your hard work. See, that's the value again. Look how hard you worked on that. You might have pulled it up, and it took you 5 minutes to actually do the research on it. Guess what? They don't know that. Assume the close and make the deal. After the sale, we go right back to marketing. We finish the sales process. We go right back to marketing. Thank you. Follow up. Drip. Let's start working for the next one. Making sure they're going to be happy on this one. Thank you. Don't just count your money, right? Get yourself in a position to keep that money turning. Buy them something. Buy them a gift. Send them a thank you card. Make sure that their experience has you in it. When they arrive at their vacation destination, make sure there's a little something in the room from you with your name on it, because no other travel agent is going to do that for them. Travelocity is not going to do that for them. Expedia is not going to do that for them. Orbitz isn't going to do that for them. Only you're going to do that for them. And they're going to thank you. They're going to remember that. They know that when they book with you, it's special. You care about them. You're leaning on that relationship. All right. That's the sales process. I love selling, and selling is great. And it's just in me. I've been doing it a long time, but you know, it's something that you have to learn how to do. But the great news about it is everybody can learn how to sell. It is not something that is a gift. It's not something that, you know, you have to be talkative. You have to listen. You know, you have to really go at it with the same proportions that, you know, God gave you, two ears and one mouth. Sales is not common sense. If it was common sense, more people would do it. What it is learning something that most people never learn. Sales is an art. It is not just something that you just pick up. You are not going to learn how to sell just because you spent an hour with me on this call tonight. You have to practice. You have to take these things, write them down, learn this sales process. When I first learned the sales process, I wrote it down on a piece of paper and actually carried it with me. So it takes a long time to get to the point where you just flow with this, but you have to start. So until you get to that point, and the funny thing is, look at me, I'm 47 years old, and I'm still teaching the same steps that I learned when I was 21. Because other people have 8 steps. Some sales processes have 10 steps. Some have 5. They all do the same thing, just depends on how they're broken up. But I've been teaching the same steps since I was 21 years old. Most salespeople, or they call themselves salespeople, if you ask them, could you just kind of describe to me the steps you go through when you sell? They can't even give you any steps. So again, the greatest salespeople take the time to learn their craft so they know what they're doing. That way I know when I'm selling where I'm getting caught, where I'm not making progress. I can actually tell you where I'm not making progress. You know what? I'm stuck. I'm not getting along with this person. I'm not able to really create a relationship or a unique identity with this person. They're kind of weird. They're not fitting. I'm having a hard time with that. Or this person's not giving me the information that I need to qualify them. Right? I can't commit this person. I'm having a hard time committing. So now what you're doing is you actually know at what part of the sales process you're coming up against resistance. And what great salespeople do when they come up to a point in the sales process where they get resistance, they backtrack a couple steps and redo them a little bit and then come back to it. Because usually when that happens, you miss something. You can't get a commitment because the value wasn't there. Maybe they're not as comfortable with you yet. Maybe you haven't exhausted that need to shop yet. You see what I'm saying? So generally, as you go through the sales process, at any point you get to a step and it stops, you need to just backtrack a little bit and work a little bit more on a previous step. That's key. That's why it's important to know the process. Okay, here is the campaign manager. Now, the campaign manager has now been upgraded, and it works so simple now. And everything about it is coded with the information that you populate in About Me. And that's why it's important to be on these calls, so you know why everything has to be populated. Why your About Me section, not just your About Me section, but even the content section of About Me. Your SEO descriptions, your pictures, logos, websites. Everything needs to be populated so that the campaign manager works off of that information. So now we have different ways that you can blast. One is a standard email. With a standard email, this is just like you going into your Outlook or your Gmail or whatever, and you're just going to send one single email to one single person, and it's really, really simple and really fast. It's going to have your footer on it. So whatever theme that you chose, it'll have that theme as your footer within the template. So this will be your theme, depending on which theme you chose. This will be your default template or letterhead type for your email, okay? And it'll be destination specialist, and it'll have, you know, whatever info that you'll have there. This isn't populated, but it'll have all your info in there, okay? So that's the preview of that. When you click on it, it just simply takes you to the editor, and you just simply type in, and now what we've done is it actually tells you, hello, Jessica Henderson, this is the area to update your text. Please replace and put your content here. So now we're telling you where to write. You just simply type in over this information whatever you want. And then your email will then go to the next slide. You'll be able to preview exactly what your email is going to look like, and you go ahead and send it. Very, very simple. Now, for the blaster. By the time you guys get on this, there'll be a whole slew of brand new templates. We've pulled some of them out. We're updating all the templates so you guys can have a fresh chunk of templates with all the current promotions that are out there right now in travel. So we scour the globe and find out all the hot deals that are out there, in addition to the standard birthday and different things like that. Thank you, blah, 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 blah. So you always have something current to send to your clients in the form of a blast. All right, all the templates now are right here. You'll just be able to click this button and it'll scroll across and show you all the various templates so you don't have to scroll to the bottom of the screen. And then you just choose a template. So that'll be your basic template. All right? Now, what you're going to do, though, is you're going to select it. And once you select, you're going to choose the theme that you want. This can just be a message from your travel agent. So this is just a simple message that you can send to everybody, a message from your travel agent. It's going to pull in your picture. It's going to pull in your name, your email address, your social media buttons. And this is a nice one, just has a nice pencil. It's like from the desk of Jessica Henderson, just from the desk of you. It's just a message. You're not selling anything. That's this type of header, okay? You just need to send them a message about something. At the bottom of the email is going to be the footer, you know, where it's coming from. And where it says body, that's where the body will be. It automatically pops the body in there, in that middle part. You just have to choose your header. Your other choice, travel news clips, tips and trips. This is just kind of a fun email of various things that are going on in the travel world. You could talk to them about what's going on with the passport requirements. You can talk about what's going on around the world. You can send them some tips about travel. You can even talk about some various trips that are going on. So it's just kind of a travel clips, tips and trips, just something that you're sending. It's not a personal email. That would be the top header. This is just more of a travel related email. So you would choose that header. And that header will sit right on top of your email. Or you can choose a hot deal. And here's where you would find the hottest deals out there, something special, last minute, and whatever. But basically, you would use this template if you're actually promoting deals. You want them to look at this. You want to send this out. You put the subject that attracts them. You know, you might say hot deals. You might say last minute specials when you do your subject. And then you've got, you know, the header that basically goes with that same theme, which is going to make people go, okay, what's hot? What's hot? What's hot? You know, no down payment, free this, you know, whatever. So you'll be able to choose this template. And then all you do is you simply just click the template, and that's the header that you're going to choose. So that email blast will go out with that header. So basically what we've done is we've simplified it into three sections. And then there's one more where you can actually create your own template. And I will show you that when we actually go into this and I teach you guys how to use all this stuff. I'm not going to do it tonight. We're done for the night. But you can actually do your own. So if you see a great email from Sunwing or Carnival or anyone and you like it and you want to take that email, make it your own, and then blast it out to your people, you can do that too. It works the similar way, except you would simply select a blank template. Once you select a blank template, you would choose the header that you want. Then you would take you to the preview screen, and you would copy and paste the exact part of that other email or wherever you got what you want, and you paste it in. You edit it however you want to edit it, the text. You might take out the supplier phone number, put your phone number in, or whatever, and then you hit enter, and what will happen is that email will blast with your header, your information, your footer, and just the guts of the special. So now you're blasting out Carnival specials, you're blasting out Royal Caribbean specials, and they don't have any ability to call Royal Caribbean or Carnival. You put it together. It's almost as if you created it yourself. It's almost as if you have your very own design team, and you're creating all these emails on the fly and sending them out, and your people are going to simply go, wow. So again, all of this stuff works off of a completed About Me section. So again, we're going to be talking about this on the next call to make sure that you guys have everything in place so that you can begin to use this as your go-to system so that every one of you can start marketing like never before, because marketing is the key. Sales is great. We talked about the sales process tonight, and that's awesome. But marketing's the key. If you know how to sell and don't have anybody to talk to, we all know what that's going to get us. A shark told me if they want it, they'd buy it with no process. You know what? And if you believe that, you'll find out that they won't. You never shortcut the process. Don't be fooled. Remember what I said. Don't be fooled by what the client says. Do your job so that you know, okay? Once you populate your About Me, each of you will have your own Pro Travel Network email address. It'll be jhenderson@protravelnetwork.net or cmikhail@protravelnetwork.net. Again, giving you that full feeling that you work and you are a travel agent. You know, much more powerful than jessicahenderson@gmail.com. Well, are you a travel agent or not? Well, I am, but I use Gmail. Well, come on. I mean, if you book from Flight Center, they're going to send you an email that says john@flightcenter.com or john@flightcenter.net. If you book from Expedia, you're going to get an email back from billy@expedia.com or billy@expedia.net, right? So you need an email address that goes along with the branding. Okay, so we've really gone through the whole system to try to really get you guys a program that lets you be as professional as you want. Again, the key is, though, you've got to populate the content. We're not even going to let you have access to this without populating the content. It's that important. If we're going to put it out there, I mean, the last thing we want is an email going out and there's images missing or there's data missing because it wasn't populated. I hope that makes sense to everybody. It needs to look professional and the right way. All right, everybody, that's it. Everybody have a great night. Sorry the call went long, and we will see you Tuesday night. And this will be the big one. We're going to be talking about commissions, markups, service fees, booking net. It's a powerful call. If you want to learn how to make money, you want to get on that call, we will also be covering the final details of the About Me Campaign Manager and Inbox. Good night, everybody.